trying for quite a few years now to work less with the computer, because I think that we interact with the computer all the time in daily life. I mean, our phones are computers these days. And I found myself getting a bit tired of everything. Also, my eyesight is not perfect. So for me, working more with hardware as opposed to working with software was a way to help myself getting a bit more distance between me and the screen. The advantage of modular for me is that it's physical. For me, the computer more and more is like a glorified tape machine. I just record things onto it, but the creation itself happens on hardware. So the advantage of modular for me is first of all that. And secondly, I think the possibilities that you can achieve through these infinite connections which are possible in a modular system. Like every day is a new day full of endless connectivity. That for me is very appealing. And thirdly, I think out of all the regions of the music industry, which have been for a long time now extremely commercialized, the modular scene and the manufacturers who make these modular systems, I think are doing very creative stuff right at the moment. They're doing amazing things. I sometimes think that the manufacturers are more creative than the people who are using the modules, because you sometimes hear like vaguely identical things coming out of it. But I think that's amazing. Like the modular manufacturers at the moment are just on a total roll. And it's fantastic to see that level of creativity in small companies who don't have big marketing budgets, but who are really doing this from the heart. And that for me is another aspect why I like modular synthesis so much. One of the things that modular systems do, once you start into it, playing with them, they provide you with a better understanding of sound. And I don't think I would be able to understand sound as deeply as I do now if it weren't for the modular system. If I would have stayed with software and a couple of drum machines, I would not have had the knowledge that I have now. One part of the system actually is almost bought entirely the way it is. It's the make noise shared system, which I had modified a little bit, but basically I bought it the way it is. And I bought it because it is exactly laid out the way it is, and it kind of feels like an instrument. It doesn't feel like a case full of modules. And then later on I started building a second make noise system, which completely consists out of modules which I have chosen and my layout. And then there's two other cases where basically there is no logic and anything goes. So if I have some room here, I'll slot the module in there. And then, you know, because things change once in a while. So there's half of the system is sort of rational and the other half is pure chaos. Next to the modular, there is not that much I use, except if I need like, let's say longer sounds, pad sounds, wide classic synth sounds. There is the big JX10, the Super JX, which is an older Roland machine, which is I think one of the last real analog machines they built in the 80s before they started moving into the digital evolution. This is like a massive 12 voice analog monster, which is basically one of the things I use to get like the classic synth sound. The main clock is the computer, so Pro Tools sends out a clock. This clocks everything you see here, so all the drum machines, effects if necessary, clocks the H9, and it also clocks the whole modular system. 80% of all the sequences are done on the modular, which means that I don't have to start to draw notes on the screen. Most of it is done in the modular. There's like an analog 4 from Electron, which is also running in sync, which I usually just use to sequence the modular, not for its own sounds, but I use it to sequence the modular. There's a René sequencer from Make Noise in there, which is very powerful. There's a couple of other bits and pieces that I use to kind of make sequences that are not like your standard 16th note sequence. And then everything else, basically like pad sounds or melodies, I will play by hand and record into the computer. So while recording, whether it be through the modular or from the synthesizers, everything goes through this Tegeler audio compressor, which is actually a Burnin made fantastic piece of equipment. It provides you with kind of a warm tube coloration. It's not really distortion. I mean, you can really crank it up if you want to, but I usually just use it a little bit to warm up the sound. And then depending on what I'm using, if it's rhythms, for instance, coming from the modular, I'll probably just add some delay or something to make it a bit more rolling and grooving. And then everything goes into the computer. And that's basically where everything is edited down again. For recording, everything is running through a Lynx Aurora 16 channel, which is basically a mastering grade converter. Allows me to record 16 mono channels at once, if needed. Of course, before the sound gets into the sound card, it passes through the APB desk. So this analog desk is basically the first port of call for all the machines, and then that goes to the Lynx, and the Lynx goes to the computer. I try to do as much EQing as possible on the mixer because it just sounds fantastic. It's full analog, it has two parametrics. It's a beautiful, beautiful piece of equipment. And if needed, I'll do some fine tuning afterwards in Pro Tools. But it's usually my aim to get the sound into the computer already as best equalized as possible. Probably the most important piece of equipment in this studio, apart from the modular system, is this thing here, which is the Trinov Audio Room Correction System. And this system basically processes all the audio before it goes to the speakers. It has been fine-tuned to the characteristics of this room. So what happens is the processor basically evens out all the acoustic imbalances that are in this room and then sends sounds to four speakers, basically two focals here that you see, and two sub-bass speakers that are in the back. So the speakers are very important, but I think the room correction system is even more important. Without that system, I would not be able to get into the mix and hear clearly what is wrong. This has changed my life completely.